actually testifies that he's Christian. So we know that in the Christian Bible today that say that are not from God. They're not from Allah. So we can use this to discriminate between the good and the bad, the right and the wrong.
Let's use false evidence
for the unbelievers. The problem is that Jesus is the word of Allah. Agreed? Now, if the word of Allah became man, Jesus was a man. So the word of Allah became flesh. John 1:1, the word of Allah was with God, and the word became flesh. So they're in agreement with one another. So the word of Allah became a man. That's what the Christians do.
This is your benefit,
the Quran,
not mine.
Yeah, the Quran also invented
Sister, can I share with you another hadith? This comes from Bukhari. This is the most reliable and authentic corpus of hadith that we have. And it says this, Ibn Abbas says, why do you ask the people of the scripture, that's the Jews and the Christians, anything while your book, the Quran, which has been revealed to Allah's apostle, is newer and the latest? You read it pure, undistorted and unchanged. And Allah has told you that the people of the book have changed their scripture and distorted it and written the scripture with their own hands and said, it is from Allah to sell it for a little gain. It goes on. This is a Bukhari hadith. This corroborates the teaching of the Quran that the Jews and the Christians have altered and changed their books. But there's still some truth left, even in the scriptures we have today. And so we can refer to them.
Does the Quran authenticate the Bible?
Sorry?
How many times does the Quran authenticate the Torah and the Injil? How many times?
It's an important point here.
More times.
It authenticates the original Torah and the original Injil. And how many Injil we have today?
The Jewish Torah is still the same.
No.
You have to bring the evidence to show where it's been.
I'm talking as a Muslim about the Quran. The Quran and the Hadith both bear witness that the Torah has been changed, distorted, corrupted, and lost, forgotten in part.
At the same time,
it happens.
So make up your mind.
I see it up my mind. Also, the Gospel has been changed. I can talk to you on the basis of the Quran and modern Western biblical scholarship.
Why is Allah telling me to go and judge by the Gospel?
Because if you're asking to come, no, as a Jew, if you're coming as a Jew,
confirming the scriptures, books that came before it, and Muhammad, trustworthy and highness of witness over them. So judge among them these extant scriptures by what Allah has revealed, and follow not their vain desires, diverting you away from the truth that has come to you. So if we follow what the Christians say in their scriptures, they will lead us astray. Which verse?
47.
47. You read it out there.
No, it's yours. You can run it.
Okay. Let the people of the Injil, that's the Gospel, judge by what Allah has revealed therein.
I hardly
can. And whoever does not judge by what Allah has revealed,
what?
Then such people are the rebellious or disobedient to Allah.
I am a Christian. What should I judge by?
The Quran.
What's the next verse?
Read the verse again. Read the verse again.
Okay. And in their
you know, it refers to a specific incident which you told us, yeah?
No, what refers is the Jew. Remember,
the Jew.
Now I'm not the Christian. But I hear what you're saying.
Let me just read it again. I'll read it for the verse before that. And in their footsteps, we sent Isa, that's Jesus, son of Mary, confirming the Torah that had come before him. Now, that's not necessarily the Torah we have today.
Hang on,
I'm reading it.
It's a Torah.
No, he doesn't say that. It says to Jesus, not at that time. Alright? We gave him the Torah, the Injil, in which was guidance and light and confirmation of the Torah that had come before it. Not in 2019.
So at that time, the Torah they had was the correct Torah.
That's it again.
Agreed?
No.
Your Quran just confirmed that.
No.
The Torah of the time of Muhammad was a correct Torah.
No. The Quran is a quality control over the distorted and corrupted scriptures. It already says that in verse 48.
Let me ask you.
I'm still trying to read it. So whoever does not judge by what Allah has revealed, then such people are the disobedient.
During the time of
Jesus, and we have sent down to you Muhammad the book in truth, confirming the scriptures that came before it, and Muhammad over it. Muhammad means testifying to the truth that is therein and fortifying the falsehood that is therein. The gospel that Jesus preached, is it the same gospel that Christians preach today? Because I would say it is completely different.
Good job we don't believe in you then, isn't it? We'd be lost if we trusted you.
I've got biblical scholars that I can quote now. What Jesus preached.
You believe the Quran is the word of God.
Okay, look.
You read the Quran.
Why would you answer my question?
I have a question about what you read.
Why would you answer my question?
You're not being fair. You've just been speaking. Let the young man speak.
I'm asking him a question.
No.
They asked me to read it out. I read it out. No, I'm asking you a question.
No, I asked you to read one verse. I read three or four. Which is
why? Power for your money.
Which is why?
You're lucky I gave you extra two.
Why was it so emotional?
More power for your money.
Why was it so
emotional? So now I'm asking you a question.
I'm speaking to the crowd and all of that.
When Jesus preaches the gospel, what is his message? According to the gospels in the Bible and according to the Quran. I'm glad you're a friend.
You're very funny,
guy. Listen. Thank you.
As a Christian, what does Allah say that I should do? What should I use to judge by?
Become a Muslim.
Is that what he says? what he said about.
No, you're asking me?
I'm asking you according to the Quran. The thing you just read.
You should follow Muhammad.
Don't keep it there. Bring it out and read it.
Let me tell you.
What does it say?
I'll tell you. You've got to listen.
It's the last time.
The Quran is clear. Muhammad, peace be upon him, is the last messenger sent to mankind. And that all mankind should listen to his message for the good of their salvation. To avoid hellfire and to go to paradise. It also says that Christians should stop worshipping Jesus as God, because that is a great blasphemy against the sovereignty of our glorious Lord. You must stop worshipping God and follow the pure teaching of Muhammad. That's what the Quran says to you as a Christian. Now it's my turn to ask you a question. What is the gospel that Jesus preached?
I'm not carrying on this conversation because I don't think you
were
involved.
I think I've done my job. Stop worshipping Jesus and come back to the original religion of Jesus, which happens to be the same as Islam. If you look at the teaching, it's exactly the same. Isn't that interesting? So what Christians believe today is not the same thing as Christians. When the science gone wrong,
there's no actual one
now.
You know what I mean? It's the best. I could be here showing all day.
I'll update your software. Get rid of your Microsoft and you need to update it, upgrade it to Apple to use an analogy.
I'm going to have to tell you, if I'm being sabotaged, I'll leave. As simple as that, right? So this is what I'm saying, yeah? We were on the 45 your brother, he mentioned 48, and you were listening to what he's saying, right? He read the commentary about it. Fair enough. Commentary is not Quran, is it? Commentary is interpretation of it by somebody, right? Now, my question was, according to the commentary that he's saying, there was a corruption, right? And my question is, okay, read the verse before, 47, and tell me as a Christian, what should I use to judge? What is my scripture? Where should I go? Your brother said Quran.
I'll show you the passage. Right?
Now, if you read, this is a Quran given by Muslims, okay? So I'm not trying to fool anyone. Okay, it's right here. As a Christian, according to the verse, what am I supposed to
judge among them by what Allah has revealed, which is the Quran.
What am I supposed to
That's the answer.
Okay. If you're just going to take verse 47 without taking the verse after
the context,
and you're not going to take into consideration at the time it was revealed and for what circumstances it was revealed under, you're going to go reading that and you're going to ignore the verse after it and the verse before it. You're going to say, oh, it says the Quran says I must believe in the Bible, so I'm going to believe in the Bible.
But we both know that I haven't done that.
No,
I was the one who brought you that story, right?
Yeah.
So I'm not doing that, right? I'm not doing that. I'm not trying to do that. Now, what I'm reading is in the context of the story, right? In the context of the story. I believe I can give you an interpretation that actually makes sense of the whole story. My problem is your interpretation is contradicting verses. It's not making sense, okay? And that's what I want to engage with you.
I'm not saying that just to reinforce my view. I'm saying that because what you're saying, I kind of genuinely disagree with. Because I don't think that verse is saying what you think it's saying.
Okay, tell me what it means.
Exactly.
We've had this thing. I think it's referring, when it's telling you to judge by your book, it's telling you, following that story, the prostitute coming to the Muslim saying, I want to be punished by the Muslim punishment, not by the Jewish punishment. And he's saying, that God has revealed that verse, saying, why are you coming to the Muslims and asking for the Muslim thing when your book says this?
Okay, so those are the Jews. I'm not talking about the Jews anymore. I'm going forward because he doesn't stop talking about the Jews.
Then he talks about the gospel.
Christians, yeah?
The gospel.
So the Christians.
Okay. So what we're saying is, we don't doubt that the gospel was real and that it was word of God at one point. What we're saying is the message was distorted. Now, some verses are still true. Some of them are still accurate verses of God. And if the Quran doesn't contradict it in any of those verses, then I'm going to accept that that's true.
I hear you. So judge among them.
Who changed it?
I can ask all those for you.
Yeah, you guys maybe should have a debate tomorrow.
When we finish with you, we will. When we finish with you, we will.
Some rabbis and scribes changed it for worldly good. Worldly good. Okay? Whatever that is, maybe it affected their business, maybe it affected some sort of income. I don't know what the reason
for that is. So at least one more question, and I'll leave it at this. God,
actually,
you believe in God, don't you?
This is God, is that correct?
Yeah. Why couldn't God protect the Bible at the time of the Jews, yet he can do it? So the Quran, that shows a weak God?
No, it
doesn't.
The Quran addresses that very point. The Quran says that God has...
Well, ask some questions, answer.
The Quran actually has an answer to that. Well, here, let me just hear. Give me 30 seconds to deal with it. The Quran says that God has given the rabbis and so on, the scribes, the job of protecting their own scriptures, but God will preserve the Quran himself. Because this is... Because this is to the all of mankind, sister, this is for all mankind, whereas those were particular books to particular people. Jesus was sent, as he says in Matthew chapter 15, I'm only sent to the lost sheep of the house of Israel. Muhammad said he's been sent as a mercy to all of the world. God will preserve this, and he has actually, even Western scholarship acknowledges, the Quran we have today is the same Quran we had 1,400 years ago. The original Torah and the Gospel are not the same, as I can quote hundreds of scholars from the top universities, most of them Christian, who agree with that statement, and you know this because I debated you before.
I heard what you're saying, but unfortunately you just didn't answer the question itself. I heard what you're saying and I understand it.
Yeah.
But the question is, what is your interpretation of the verse?
Yeah.
Not somewhere else, but the verse.
The gospel judge by what Allah has revealed therein. Okay?
So what does that mean?
Okay, to me, therein, what was revealed in the gospel. Because we're told later on in many places in Quran that the gospel was revealed, but then it was changed. Yeah. So what he's saying here, reveal to believe in what was revealed, not in what was changed. Yeah. To believe in what was revealed.
Okay, enough. Some people say it was lost.
Maybe. I don't know what happened.
So technically they don't know what is true.
I can see how they thought that happened because that's what was visible at the time. But the Quran tells us what actually happened.
Let's just think for a bit, yeah? If we say that they should check basically with the Quran, with Muhammad, right? What is true and false. Mm-hmm. Then technically they should check everything about the gospel. Because if I have a gospel that's corrupted, if I'm a Christian at the time, I have a gospel that's corrupted. Mm-hmm. I have no idea what has been corrupted or not.
Yeah.
So each verse that I'm reading...
Therefore, so judge among them by what Allah has revealed. So you just use the Quran, the Christians use the Quran to judge the truth of what's left.
Each verse that I'm reading,
judge among them by what Allah has revealed.
I have no idea. So technically, each verse, I have to go to Muhammad and check it.
No. By the Quran, it says,
would that make sense for Allah to tell me to do that rather than just go straight to Muhammad and get the Quran?
No. Then you go, you adopt Islam, and it's done. You sorted. You don't.
But he doesn't say that. Is that what he said? He doesn't say adopt Islam. He says, you are Christians, it's fine. Just follow the gospel.
Yeah, because it says, to you be your religion and to be ours. There's no compulsion in your religion. You can worship or believe in what you like. However, it tells you what the truth is and is referred to. The
I can be a Christian. It's fine if I'm a Christian.
Authentic stuff.
It was when the time. Is it now? What's the difference?
You know what? Because on that point, I think it's a good point to raise. Because even me, and there's some verses in there that refer says
and they cover it over
the good even though, Christians even though and Jews even though they may will be going to hell as well. That's what it says, yeah?
From what I've read, there's contradicting terms of
situation. Okay, so it says something like that. So I thought about that. I said, does that mean, is it condoning or accepting
I think that's what
Christianity and Judaism? To me, as far because I know because one of the verses that we received as a declaration of faith is to accept Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, as a messenger. Okay? That's for you to believe that, because like to me, what I think is, you know the version of Christianity that you believe, you're not following it as much as the Muslims are following it. That's what I think.
So do you believe Jesus as your savior?
I believe him as a prophet.
So you're not following Christianity, are you?
Yeah. Why? No, Christianity is a man-made religion. The gospel of Jesus is different.
Is it? Did you ever see this?
Yes. Okay, I refer you to a video that you and I had a debate about. It's over 100,000 viewers. Go and watch that video again.
I'm trying to dig a little deeper into the actual context of the story and trying to hear you guys speaking, right? So what you're telling me is that, okay, at that time, there was a gospel, they had an Injil, right? And this book had parts true, parts false.
No, at the time it was revealed it was true.
No, at this time.
Okay, yeah.
So at this time had parts true, parts false, right? Now, as a Christian, at the time, let's say as a Christian at the time, I have no idea what has been revealed, what was true or false, right?
Yeah.
So I would have to go to Muhammad for
to judge
each verse
among them by what God has revealed.
What has he revealed?
The Quran.
Do you follow what I'm saying? Just forget what Paul's saying for a second. You can hear us. But just follow what I'm saying and see if it makes sense, that narrative. I, as a Christian, would have to check each verse to see whether it's still true or not. Does that make sense? Or would it not make sense if that's true for Allah to tell me, as a Christian, to go straight to Muhammad? Because he's got the criteria, he's got the preserved word. But if he has, then what he should say here is, and let the people of the gospel judge by what Allah has revealed to you.
I think you've got it completely mixed up. You're not taking all the verses in context, verse 49 to 50. You're taking on one verse and you're trying to spin a whole story out of it. If you look at all the verses, all four verses, it's very clear that the people of the people of the book of the scriptures have corrupted and changed the scriptures. But thankfully, but the Quran is itself that which testifies to the truth that is therein and falsifies the falsehood that is added therein. And the Quran is how we know that.
That's the meaning. I want to know this word.
I'm
reading to you the Quran.
No, you're not. You're reading English. That's not the Quran.
So have you read the Quran? Have you read the Quran?
Excuse me. Let me make this clear.
So have you read the Quran?
You're not reading the Quran.
Have you read the Quran?
Yes.
In Arabic? Do you read Arabic?
Yes.
You understand in Arabic?
Not all of it, but a lot of it.
Do you understand Arabic, Quran?
Yes, I've read Surah Al-Fatiha in Arabic. I understand it. I've read other verses.
So you haven't read the Quran?
I've read various verses. But hang on, this is not about me.
I want to knock this myth on the head.
Sister, yeah. Let me knock this myth on the head. What this chap is reading from here is not the Quran, as we Muslims have
thought.
This is a translation.
What he says is the noble Quran.
No, this is a translation of the meanings of the Quran. It's not the Quran itself.
He says it
on the cover. Look, English meanings.
That's right. Same as
not the original Quran.
And the original.
No. Can I finish? Let me finish. Can I say something, please? Now, these translators are Arabic who know the language. Brother, you're not listening. Now, these translators who know the Arabic, they are Arab, they're from Saudi themselves, they have told me, an English-speaking reader, because they have the credentials. If you look into the biography, they are top scholars.
Says who?
Will you just let me finish?
Yeah, I'm asking questions.
Now, the Arabic word, Muhammad, means, in Arabic, this is what Arabic scholars tell us, me, an Englishman, it means this, and he's talking about